based on Klingon transmissions we've intercepted, the outlying Cardassian colonies were overrun almost immediately. But now that the Cardassian fleet is mobilized, the Klingons are meeting stronger resistance.
You'd almost think somebody warned the Cardassians they were coming.
Hopefully, it'll make the Klingons think twice about what they're doing.
Unlikely, Major. Now that the battle has begun, Martok and his troops will settle for nothing less than victory.
Well, what does the Federation Council say?
They've decided to condemn the Klingon invasion. In response, Gowron has expelled all Federation citizens from the Klingon Empire and recalled his ambassadors from the Federation.
You're saying he cut off diplomatic relations?
He's done more than that. The Klingons have withdrawn from the Khitomer Accords. The peace treaty between the Federation and the Klingon Empire has ended.
Captain, you're never going to believe this. A Klingon ship just decloaked off Upper Pylon 3 and is requesting permission to dock. They claim they have Chancellor Gowron on board, and he is demanding to speak with Mr. Worf personally.
Chancellor Gowron, you wish to speak with me?
Worf! Worf! It is good to see you. I always said that uniform would get you into trouble one day.
It seems you are right. But I do not apologize for my
act. Yes, I know. You did what you thought was right. And even though you may have made some enemies, I assure you, I am not one of them.
I am glad. Your friendship means much to me.
And yours to me. It has been too long since you last fought at my side. Now the time has come again. You will do great deeds in the coming days. Deeds worthy of song.
You want me to go to Cardassia with you?
What better way to redeem yourself in the eyes of your people? Come with me, Worf. Glory awaits you on Cardassia. Worf! Why do you stand there like a mute block? I have offered you a chance for glory. All you have to do is take it.
If there's any glory to be won, Gowron, it'll have to be yours alone. I cannot come with you.
Of course you can. It is where you belong.
No, I cannot abandon my post.
You no longer have a post. You have no place on that station and no business wearing that uniform.
I have sworn an oath of allegiance.
To the Federation!
You would have me break my word.
Your word? What good is your word when you give it to people who care nothing for honor, who refuse to lift a finger while Klingon warriors shed blood for their protection? I tell you, they are without honor. And you do not owe them anything!
It is not what I owe them that matters. It is what I owe myself. Worf, son of Moog, does not break his word.
And what of your debt to me? Are you saying you owe me nothing? Gave you back your name, restored your house, gave your family a seat on the High Council, and this is how you repay me?
It is true. I owe you a great debt. I would give up my life for you. But invading Cardassia is wrong, and I cannot support it.
Worf, I have always considered you a friend and an ally. And because you are my friend, I am giving you this one last chance to redeem yourself. Come with me.
I cannot.
Think about what you are doing. If you turn your back on me now, for as long as I live, you will not be welcome anywhere in the Klingon Empire. Your family will be removed from the High Council, your land seized, and your house stripped of its titles. You will have nothing.
Accept my honor.
So be it.